Many times work does not interest us. We feel compelled to abandon it because our mind is not in it anymore. This is because most times mind is under the influence of ignorance. It is under inertia. The mind which is full of wanted and unwanted content can cause dullness, dreariness and heaviness. The most evident cause of the mind losing sharpness is expectancy of the result of our actions. In the modern world, we are trained unconsciously by our family and society to perform actions, but doing it with our eyes fixated on the result of work or action. This approach blunts the mind, and hence the mind becomes overburdened and heavy with expectations. More often than not, expectations are not met. This will then result in loss of interest in work. Mind becomes incapable of focusing on further work. The antidote to inertia is to first divert the mind to other activities or to subjects in which the mind is interested. Yet, one must be conscious that one does not drain the mind further by indulging in unnecessary gossip, negative thoughts, addictive practices like playing video games or watching too many movies. These things should be strictly avoided. One may take up gardening or light exercises, yoga, meditation, learning an art form, or other practices so that the mind gains its lost sharpness. Playing outdoor or indoor games without conscious effort towards winning the game can be extremely exhilarating and relaxing for the mind. As you do these activities, slowly the mind regains its vigor. It will then be much simpler to refocus on work. Work should be performed akin to playing an interesting game. Work should be done for the sheer joy of doing work. At no point should one hook the mind to the outcome of work. Goals should be set prior to starting work. One should work moving positively towards the goal. Yet, one has to train oneself to be free of the outcome of the performed work, knowing well that the outcome is beyond our scope. Understanding the teachings enunciated in the Bhagavad Gita can help us become free of feelings attached to the outcome of work. This should be done as a conscious practice. The more one disengages from results, absorption in the work at hand shall proportionately increase. Strange, but surprisingly true. If we were to pour every ounce of our concentration on work without the least focus on results, one would truly discover the joy of work. A time shall come when work will become relaxation and a great release mechanism. The goal is to work diligently in such a way that mind is happy working and relaxing simultaneously without pining for a break or holiday. If this mindset is attained, one would have mastered the art of work.